This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we will introduce the expression of the kinetic energy of a system of particles, the translational kinetic energy, the rotational kinetic energy, and the kinetic energy of a system in combined translational and rotational motion.
Kinetic energy, translational kinetic energy. The moving hammer drives the nail deep into the piece of wood. So the moving hammer possesses a certain form of energy called kinetic energy. Now, what is the expression of this form of energy? For a particle moving with a speed v and having a mass m, recall that the particle is an object having a mass but zero size. So the kinetic energy of a particle is given by 1/2 mv squared. In SI, the kinetic energy is expressed in joule, the mass in kilogram, and the speed in meter per second. Now, consider a system of n particles or a system of more than one particle. As you see, particle 1 moves with a speed v1 and having a mass m1, particle 2 of mass m2 and having a speed v2, until particle n of mass mn and moving with a speed vn. So the kinetic energy of this system equal 1/2 m1 v1 squared, which is the kinetic energy of the first particle, plus 1/2 m2 v2 squared, the kinetic energy of the second particle, until 1/2 mn vn squared, which is the kinetic energy of the nth particle. From this formula, we conclude that the kinetic energy is possessed by a system due to its motion. Now, kinetic energy of a rigid object in translational motion. Watch the short animation where an object slides along the surface of an inclined plane. We notice that all the particles that constitute the object have the same speed. And we have already proved that the kinetic energy of a system of n particles equal 1/2 m1 v1 squared plus 1/2 m2 v2 squared plus 1/2 mn vn squared. Since all the particles have the same speed, so v1 equal v2 equal v3 equal vn equal v. So we can take v as a common factor and rearrange this formula. We get Ke system equal 1/2 into m1 plus m2 plus mn v squared. But we know that m1 plus m2 plus mn equal the total mass of the system, which is capital N. Then the kinetic energy of an object in translational motion equal 1/2 mv squared.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, rotational kinetic energy. Let's first discuss the circular motion of a particle. Consider this particle. It describes a circular path about O. The kinetic energy of the particle is given by 1/2 mv squared. But what is the relation between the linear speed of the particle and its angular speed? The relation is v equal r theta prime, where r is the radius of the circular path and theta prime is the angular speed of the particle. Now this is going to be 1/2 mr squared theta prime squared. But what does this term represent? As you know, this term represents the moment of inertia of the particle about O. So this is going to be Ke equal 1/2 I theta prime squared. This is the form of the kinetic energy of a particle in circular motion. Now, consider this fan. The fan blades are rotating. Each constituent particle in the fan blades describe a circular path as the one described in the previous slide. So we can express the kinetic energy of a rotating object as Ke object equal 1/2 I1 theta prime 1 squared, which refers to the kinetic energy of the first particle, plus 1 half I2 theta prime 2 squared, which refers to the kinetic energy of the second particle, and finally 1 half In theta prime n squared, the kinetic energy of the nth particle. But take into account that the fan blades are considered as a rigid object. So all the particles in the fan blades have the same angular velocity theta prime at any instant. So we will replace theta 1 prime and theta 2 prime and theta n prime by only theta prime. Now theta prime is common, it's the same for all particles, so it will be taken as a common factor. Now, what does this term represent? I1 plus I2 and finally In. It represents the moment of inertia of the object with respect to the axis of rotation delta. So I, object with respect to delta, equal I1 plus I2 and finally plus In. So we will express it as I. So this is going to be Ke object 1 half I theta prime squared. So this is the formula that gives you the kinetic energy of a rigid object in rotation. Now let's talk about the SI units. In SI, kinetic energy is expressed in joule, as you know, and the moment of inertia in kilogram meter squared and theta prime in radian per second. Now look at I. I is a positive quantity and theta prime is also, theta prime squared is a positive quantity. So the kinetic energy of a rotating object is a positive quantity.
Kinetic energy of a system in combined translational and rotational motion. First, what do we mean by combined translational and rotational motion? Let's watch this short animation where a ball slides down along the surface of a rough inclined plane. We notice that the center of mass of this ball is in translational motion, while the ball is in rotational motion about an axis passing through its center of mass. Therefore, the kinetic energy of a rigid object in combined translational and rotational motion equal the kinetic energy of translation, which is the kinetic energy of the center of mass of the ball, plus the kinetic energy in case of rotation of the ball. We know that the kinetic energy of the center of mass of the ball equal half mvg squared, and the rotational kinetic energy of the ball equal 1 half I theta prime squared. Vg is the speed of the center of mass, m is the total mass of this object, I is the moment of inertia of this object about its axis, and theta prime is the angular speed of the object.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.